Hi everyone, Chef en Mark Doors in the Low Countries. Now this is a steel O2 6 chainsaw and there were two things wrong with it. The first was that the chainsaw was behaving weird, which means that there was something wrong with the anti-vibration system. The second is that when I put it off, it didn't shut off. So I used the choke to turn it off, which of course is not how you should do it, but yeah, that's the way that I solved it. So let's now have a look what's wrong with this old O2-6. Now the anti-vibration system is connected to three points. The first one is over here, which is still fine. The second one is over here, which was also fine. I unscrewed it, but it's fine. And the third one is over here. And this is the troublemaker. Now what you see is that it has turned loose. This is also not an original steel anti-vibration rubber. Now I think this is not even that old. I think I placed this in a couple of years back. Ordered it online, I expect. But it's already broken. And that's not good. So this time I will put in an original from steel, which will last much longer than this cheap stuff. Now the second problem that I mentioned, that it didn't want to shut off when I used the switch, I also found the contact has broken loose from the cable. So this contact is here in the switch, and with the cable going to the ignition, it switches off. But it has broken loose. Now I went to the steel dealer and asked him if he had a spare cable, but he said he didn't. So I will repair this by soldering it back, which also works fine, but that I will do later. Now I unscrewed a lot of things in order to reach to the part that I wanted to see whether it's the issue. So now we're going to put it all back together and make this chainsaw work again the way it should. And the first thing that I want to do is to put the intake rubber back into place. Getting old also means that you sometimes need to have reading glasses in order to see properly. Comes with the age. Now I took the carburetor off in order to check the anti-vibration system, because otherwise this is connected towards the cylinder. And here you see the intake rubber. Now you have to bring that back so you can put the carburetor back onto the system. Now I tend to use two pliers in order to pull it back. Without destroying it, of course. Now it can sometimes be a little bit of a hassle to get the rubber back in. I just did. And in order to fixate it, you have to put in the ring. So let's put the ring back. There it goes. So I now put in the ring back, so it's now fixated. The next step is to place the carburetor back. Now the chainsaw is quite dirty. I don't dare to clean it now because I'm afraid that I will blow in dirt in the carburetor, in the cylinder, things like that. Carburetor, nevertheless, I can clean before putting it back. So let's now push the carburetor back onto the system. Make sure that this pipe is going into that hose, and that the cables are running free. Connect this hose on that back onto the tube. It's the gasoline tube. There it goes. And we can then screw the carburetor back tight. Like that. So let's now also screw our new anti-vibration rubber back to the system. Also the chain guidance can now be put back. So it has to be put back like this. Make sure it's nice horizontal before you screw it tight. it in the snap again. There it is. Also putting this side of the anti-vibration system together. And now it is properly mounted again. Now for repairing the electrical connection, we're first going to strip a little bit of the wire. And then we're going to use these two extra hands to make my work easier. Now I'm also going to put in some soldering fat in order to make sure it properly sticks. So the wire is now soldered, so it can now also be placed back into the chainsaw. So this part needs to go over here, making connection towards the ignition, like this. And then it has to go together with the other ones through this rubber, because that needs to be connected back later. There it goes. Through the hole. And now it has to be put back into the switch. So we need to push the cable through somehow. So let's use a screwdriver to open up the switch a little so I can push the cable through. There it goes. Now pushing this one back. Now it has become a little bit thicker because of the soldering. So it doesn't want to go in. So I tried soldering it at the side, but that doesn't work because then you cannot get the cable through anymore. So I'm going to unsolder it and then resolder it at the top, which gives only a very small connection, but it's the only option we have. The other option is to buy a new part. Yeah, that's the last option. It's the easiest one. Now let's see if we're able to make a top connection, which is difficult because that will be a little bit fragile. But we're going to try it anyway. So now see if I can push it back into the switch. It works. Okay. Holding the on and off switch back into the casing. So let's also use this opportunity to clean our chainsaw. Putting my finger in to prevent dirt getting into the carburetor. Oh, wait a minute, I will also put in the spark plug for the same reason. Using an old cloth for cleaning the parts. I Now the air filter I will clean with a brush. Compressed air, you will only push it further in, so I won't do that. Now the next step is to mount the throttle.
The easiest way for me to mount the throttle rod is to pull back the carburetor just a little, so I can hold the throttle level with my finger at the right position, connect the throttle rod and then push back the carburetor into position.
So the system has been put back together, it's time for a test run. Well, it runs fine again. But it needs some proper adjustment of the carburetor. So, the old O26 is working again. Everything is working properly. Switch is working. The AV system is again properly fixated. Don't use these cheap rubbers. Use original steel spare parts. In the long run, that's much better, as you can see. The carburetor needs some readjustment. Maybe because I cleaned the filter, I don't know. But that's something that I will do another time. So we hope you enjoyed the video, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.